Starting 1st of June, 12 right. weeks, all right? Top of the bill, Lena Martel. Mm. Bimbo the performing dog. Zelda the hypnotist.
What's he done?
What's he done? He's done 12 weeks of backball, that's all he's done. All right, now listen, compare, come comic, he doubles up, you win at both ends, Johnny Clamp, right? You can't go wrong. And the music, we've got a lovely little combo called the Beatles, all right? There you go. Joan of Arc haircuts and rock and roll, the kids love it.
What they do?
What do they do? About 15 minutes, they're good for a fill, they're excellent.
All right, I'll tell you what I'll do. Drop the hypnotist. I like Joan of Arc. I'll take the combo.
A few friends.
Oh, wow!
Get plenty of booze in, all right?
Yeah, yeah, look! Look, we can all have a crazy time because my parents have gone away.
Okay, bye.
Oh, yeah, oh, goodbye.
To an orgy in clean underpants.
Oh, wow!
It's Marlon Brando throwing up in your bathroom.
Oh, crazy!
Mind if we stop at the chemist up the road here? I'm feeling sick.
She was dead. I shot her through the head.
You really are the most promising illiterate of our generation, Kix.
Gum, anybody?
Write a poem about my legs, somebody.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one?
The beautiful whore called Peg. The Venus with one leg!
The only woman I ever loved.
I'd cut it off for you, Kix.
Honey, it'd just fall over.
This is a copy of Alan's latest book. I think you're going to love it, Kurt. It's 100% pure guaranteed filth, and I'm not just saying that. I know I've said all this in the past, but I think you'll probably find that's the most vile and disgusting piece of literature you'll ever read.
Angry. yes, good, good, good. But Charles, 50,000.
Kurt, you old Nazi. You really must realize what this fabulous obscenity trial has done for Alan's career. I mean, we are talking telephone numbers now, dear boy, telephone numbers.
Well, Charles, it looks as though once again you have me by the short penis hairs, yeah?
Yeah. Ah.
So we're all settled, are we? Oh, look, here's Alan now.
Charles!
Your bill, sir.
Thank you. Well, you leave this with me. And, I'll leave that with you. Beautiful, beautiful pad you have here. Who handles the insurance?
Ha! Who needs it, Daddy? The world's going to end tomorrow.
Hmm, too true. Sign this waiver, would you? Alan's dying to meet you.
Alan! It's so weird to think he is in my house. Smashing up my car! Ha! That's really him, isn't it? He did to my car. It was brilliant, really brilliant.
Well, it's going to be a great party, Desmond.
It's really free, isn't it?
No, Melbourne. Melbourne in Australia. Bloody hell!
Hi. Hi. I'm Desmond.
I'm hungry. Where'd you keep the cream?
Cream. Cream.
Where's your car, Coach Des?
No? Yeah.
Thanks.
Of a balloon, and then he said, do you want to play pat ball?
You love me, then I'm just going to kill myself, okay? Yeah, well, you're going to be very, very sorry, aren't you?
Hi, here for the weekend? Yeah, me too. But what's the weekend? I mean, 2 days, right? You sleeping with any of these people? Oh, hey, look at the beach. I mean, you got really, really nice ears. You know, I'm into underground films, but I'm on the roof at the moment. Yeah, that's a joke. Maybe it's not funny. I don't know. It's free country, so what the hell? You know Desmond? He seems kind of young, you know? I mean, I only just met him, and I don't even know if I'm sleeping with him yet or not. He's got a nice house. You know, I think I'm confused, but I don't know.
So I bashed him in the head. I mean, you know what she called me? She calls me a cold-blooded murderer.
Stop! It's too crazy! I'm turning into a Negro!
Eleanor, get to the back of the bar.
Yeah! I'm turning into an Italian! Look! Pointed shoes!
Kicks, do you remember the ruler? That big Negro with a 12-inch wang?
When we were stretching underpants for the area, yeah.
Wow.
He was living over a jazz dive near the swamp. And,
Ooh, like a tripod.
We drove south one day and picked up this strange lesbian dwarf at a roadside motel. And she had, like, this suitcase full of frogs, you know. Maybe I bought a couple, I can't remember. And Joe was being quite weird. I mean, he's a great guy and all that, but he had, like, this awful chronic gasoline habit at the time. And by the time we reached Marrakesh, he was just busting for a gallon. I mean, he was a total and utter wreck.
You're so jazz, Alan. Go on.
And I was, like, dying for a cigarette, but the man was a total fire hazard. I mean, we'd been close for years, but when he started to, you know, glow in the dark, I thought, uh-oh, it's time to split.
It's so damn crazy when you talk weird, Alan.
Yeah! Come on, everybody! Let's go crazy apeshit!
Oh, well, that's very funny, isn't it, Brenda? Look, I've got a bloody big gun in my hand and I'm not afraid to use it, you know. Look, I'm probably gonna die or end up a cripple or something, so it's your last chance to say that you love me. Shut up! All right, that's it, Brenda! Bang! 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 Oh, crikey, call the police, somebody! Ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling! Keep away, everybody! Oh, God! Oh, the pain! Oh, it's awful! Look what you've done, Brenda!
You know how I see you like this kind of weird Fellini business type? You know, where you're kind of in love with your wife, but you're screwing around because you're so rich? I mean, maybe you're corrupt, I don't know. I mean, what exactly do you do for Alan?
As little as possible.
Look, just go crazy if you want to, you know. Take your clothes off. Anything. Oh, everything's going black. Des, come here. Look what I found. Oh, yeah. Let's fuse the lights and kiss the girls.
You're crazy, Dev. You catch hold of this.
When you get a shock.
Only if there's no money in it.
This is real crime, isn't it? This is real jalai.
I don't know why I feel so crazy, Alan. Feels like I'm going through a stargate. Maybe it's the diet pills. Maybe it's Buddha.
Maybe it's that dress, Eleanor. You've been wearing it for an hour.
I only want to be happy, Alan. When I get home, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to leave Simon. Yes, I'm going to find myself a really wild jazz guitarist and shack up in a ghetto. You know, sit around on the porch all day eating ice cream. And we'd have, like, no money. You know, be really poor, but we wouldn't care. Yes, yes, and then in the evenings we take in washing and sing Negro spirituals. Mm,
you'll love Shepherd's Bush, Eleanor.
Okay, so what, you're a successful businessman, right? I mean, you're in a hurry, you got a big deal to clinch. Maybe you're impotent, I don't know. You hate your wife, okay?
My God, you really are a total menace, aren't you?
See, the thing is this, lead's very valuable because it's heavy. You see, the heavier something is, the more valuable it is. The only exception to this rule is concrete. On the other hand, diamonds are quite expensive.
Why don't you love me? Have you found somebody more interesting? don't understand. Is it something I said?
What's your old man keeping here, Des?
That's his gun cupboard.
Oh, terrific. Where's the nearest post office?
I guess you live for the moment, huh?
I am at the moment, yeah.
Crazy, what are you doing?
Well, it's pretty obvious, isn't it?
Look, I know this may sound really crass, Jeremy, but I like you. You know, I like your style. I like your naked aggression. I really like the way you don't sleep at night.
Well, people think it's easy to be a rebel. Well, it bloody isn't. People just write stupid plays about me. God, it makes me so mad!
Hi.
Come in, Charles. I want to talk to you. I really do want to talk to you, Charles.
Sure.
It's about Alan. I think I love him. Am I too square? I mean, Kix is a sweet boy, but Alan... Well, he's so famous.
I know.
And I'd do anything for Alan. It's just this leg business, Charles. It's so confusing. I mean, where does one get it done?
I think you're very attractive. A very angry young man.
Well, I am pretty fierce.
Jeremy. Are those teeth kept?
They call you an artist, but they don't want to know. In case you try to break their system, you know, in case you try to tell the truth. It's all just a stupid conspiracy. They say, be a communist homosexual, Jeremy. You know, things like that. Just on and, you know, and on. Until it's, you know, I don't know, until, oh, what's the bloody point?
Do you want to kiss me, Jeremy?
Where?
Here.
You're pretty good at snogging. Look, I know this is a bit sudden and everything. Let's get engaged. Because I think I love you. Okay?
And there was Curly bleeding from the neck. So I thought, I know what I'll do. I'll stick a tourniquet on. But when I come back, I couldn't believe it. His face had gone completely black and his hair all sticking up on end. It was amazing. He looked just like Chuck Berry.
Yeah, rhythm blues. Crazy, man.
The funny thing was, there was a strange sort of, what's the word, unearthly type smell. A bit like a Malteser. Yeah, this will make you laugh. Every time I eat a Malteser...
You think of Curly?
Yeah.
All my friends taste like diet pills.
What do I taste like, Kix?
Valium.
Yeah. I remember when Sydney died of sodomy in Singapore. We had to bury him in the wardrobe.
Come on, Kix, let's do it. I want to do it.
Charles!
We were staying at the Hilton Hotel, overlooking the Turkish bath. I think it was room 401.
Just lend me your suit and passport, just for a few hours. That's all I'm asking, Charles.
Why must you always involve me, Kix?
Because I love you, man.
Yeah, I love you too, Kix.
I want to do it to you.
What?
I want to do it to you. I can't hear you, Desmond. You'll have to speak up.
Nothing.
No, what did you say, Desmond?
I want to do it to you.
You want to do it to me? You want to do what to me? What do you mean you want to do it to me?
It.
It. You want to do it to me. Listen, everybody, Desmond wants to do it to me.
Pretty free here, isn't it?
Well, I'm not paying.
Yes, it's really going well. Everyone's having a pretty groovy time. I don't suppose it's really your scene, is it? I mean, you're pretty much the odd man out around here.
I don't know. Free scotch, no phone bill. Find it quite relaxing, really.
I guess you're really into money and business and being straight, aren't you? I mean, I just don't know what you're doing here, you know? Because we're all crazy poets.
Phew. That was pretty amazing. I never thought I could do it like that. You know, just like shaking hands. So casual. I haven't even met your parents.
So what do my parents have to do with it?
Okay. Maybe I'm a square, but I don't usually just do it with someone on a first date.
That really makes me feel good.
Would you like to see my poems? This one I wrote ages ago. Yes.
I don't know anything about you. I don't know anything about you.
Such as?
You know, where you were born, whether you like table tennis, you know, how many O-levels you've got. I don't even know if you want to ban the bomb.
It's not very good, but...
Yes, it's embarrassing, isn't it?
This one's about my first trauma. My girlfriend had just come back from boarding school when her pony Bimbo died. It's called Oh Crikey.
And I had a really crazy time at school. I was laying all the teachers and getting into everything that was going. The girls hated me. They were so jealous.
Ah, how's dinner going?
Dinner? That's a good idea. What do you fancy? There's duck, pig, hogs, eh?
Look, I think maybe you've got the wrong idea about me, Eleanor. I mean, I'm not a virgin, OK? In fact, I've slept around quite a bit, actually, and...
Well, you've certainly got the wrong idea about me, Desmond. I may be a very sensual woman, but I'm not a common nymphomaniac, OK?
Oh, come on, you must like me a bit. You wouldn't be here otherwise.
Oh, my God, you're such a drip. You really can't help yourself, can you? What is it about me that makes men do this?
I don't think this sex thing is happening, Desmond. Eleanor looks bored.
Is she?
Eleanor.
What?
When Desmond's doing that to you, does the earth move at all?
No, only the bed.
Maybe I can think of something. Let's try it this way. Forget about Desmond.
Oh, great! Go on!
You're in Cairo. You're in the maternity ward at the Cairo General. There's disease everywhere. You know, typhoid, leprosy.
Malaria, dysentery.
Measles!
Now, look, Jack, I know you're in terrible pain, so I'll keep it short. I've got your medical bill here. Look, Jack, do you really need all these drugs? Yes, yes, I know you're dying, Jack. That's why I queried it.
Oh, wow! That's so absolutely damn crazy, Alan.
Of course, he was much younger then, my dears, but I remember one time, Charles, going to bed with a koala bear, a virgin, although he didn't know at the time. She was a sweet little thing. Do anything for a banana.
You've really gone and dented it.
Yeah, you've damaged it.
Oh, no. I can start cars, but I can't seem to stop them. Come on.
How old are you?
14.
Got any younger sisters? Or pets?
Who's he?
That's Jeremy. Fancy him, do you? Eh?
Not do.
Here, Jeremy!
Don't do that!
Jeremy! Jeremy!
Hello. And who are you?
This is Judy and this is Tracy.
Oh. They're so pretty, aren't they? And clean. I think girls of 13 are so sexy, don't you?
Oh, come on, Charles. Give us a kiss, you old closet cart.
My God, is it 10 o'clock already?
Oh, come on, Charles. Let's strip off like we did in the old days. Show them that funny muscle.
I'll see you in the morning, Alan.
That's Charles. He's an unbelievable shit. I've always hated him. Isn't he fantastic?
Modern jazz, everybody! Let's go!
Go, guys! Go, sir!
Jeremy.
Not friends, really. Just people I know.
They're really stupid, aren't they?
And old.
Come on, everybody! Let's go crazy, bloody ape shit!
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
No!
Not much of a party, is it?
William was with us, I think, and we went to buy some underpants and Bloomingdale's or something, but they've got very nice ones in there. Yeah, very classy, like, you know.
Because it was your... He doesn't like your taste. And
oh, he's balmy. He's
not
so
balmy,
stupid.
Yeah. It's not even balmy.
They were lovely. They were very classy stitching, you know, with the stripes.
That was absurd. I've never seen a stupid... You know, if you're going to buy pants, you buy a pant. You don't buy...
Alan! Alan, look, I did it! I finally cut it off!
Where's the leg?
At the hospital.
But it's the leg we're interested in.